prêt et mon cœur is a book that I really wrote actually for my mother. I wanted to do something that would be a mystery story that would have this like a little bit of variation of the old locked door mystery of the old days, but bring it into the modern times and make it a noir story. So it is a story of a young man who is now 33, whose mother disappeared 20 years ago, and now 20 years later, he's sure he knows who's responsible for that. And the reason I said that I wrote it for my mother was that my mother was actually the person who introduced me to the works of Raymond Chandler. And Raymond Chandler was a huge influence for me. Mostly actually not really the plots or the mysteries in the books, but the writing. So I wanted to write a book which would combine a very poetic language, which would have a mystery, and which would be a sort of a coming of age, sort of a young man's coming to terms with what happened and how he sees life today. So it was three elements, basically: a mystery story, coming of age story, and really a poetic story, you know, told in a very, I told it as well as I could, you know, like, again, doing something with language that I hadn't done before. There are two settings in the book. One is, of course, Helsinki, which is one of the characters in all my books, actually. And the other setting is a manor house, a rich man's manor house, about 100 kilometers west from Helsinki. It's got a lot of Finnish landscape in it. It's got a lot of the seaside, which is actually very beautiful. And it's taking place in September mostly, which is my absolute favorite month of the year. It's the most beautiful month in the whole year, with trees and everything, with the nature, and it's... So I wanted to paint that kind of a landscape into the book as well. But if you're talking about Helsinki, it's either a small big town or big small town, and there's actually two sides to it. One of them is that it's this very clean, highly, the infrastructure is very good and everything works and it's very clean and it's very nice. But then you have the Helsinki that you don't really see if you're a tourist. You don't really see it, but it's there. There is a dark side to this big small town or a small big town. And I've lived in the city for basically all my life. So I've seen, of course, the good side, but I've also seen the bad side of it. And it's something that, you know, makes it a bit noir for me. And I try to make that into the books. I try to show it in a way that, you know, it's there in the shadows.